guests. It's wonderful to have y'all back today. And I'm guessing by the looks of things that people are out there in the beautiful sunshine. Yeah. Perhaps connecting with that great outdoors that is the other God experience that we all have. In unity, we honor all faith traditions and all paths to God. In unity of Olympia, we promote and nurture lives of freedom and joy through personal development and spiritual experience. And hopefully, it is my intention to inspire people to make a positive difference in the world. So I'm going to light this candle as a symbol of that divine light that shines within all of life, within us, within all of the vegetation and animals and everything about us that makes beauty so wonderful. All right, join me in prayer. Spirit, we open our hearts, our minds, every cell of our bodies to the awareness that we are of the earth, that the earth is a sacred place, and that this divine presence that lives and moves and has its being in us is everywhere at all times. We open our awareness to this presence today especially, as today is the day we have. We pray that people around the planet, people whom we know, people whom we love, and the people who we see here and there that maybe we don't love, we pray that they have this experience too of knowing their oneness with all that is. And we're grateful. Grateful that this is the truth of who and what we are. Thank you, God. Together, thank you, God. Amen. Vision and mission. Yes.
feeling good?
Yeah.
Well, my name is Steve Mazepa. Welcome to our spiritual home. In this place, we acknowledge that this is the land and water, traditionally, of the Chats and other indigenous people. The Chats people are on the Squaxin Island tribe. The surrounding mountains, valleys, shorelines, and waterways are imbued with their presence. And it's been a little while, so I'm just going to say again, I say this every once in a while, if you walk out here and you go 2 blocks down, and then you head that way, and you go about 4 blocks in that direction, when you get to the corner of 4th Avenue and Columbia Street, right now there's a comic book store on the one side of the street, and Cascadia Grill, that's what it is, on the other corner. Right there is where there was a village of people. And about 75 people lived there permanently. And they had family, and right out by the falls where the old brewery is. And there were about 250 people that were there permanently. And between them and over by what we call Squaxin Park now, was another group of people, and they were all family, and they all lived through here. And so these words are great and important, but I like to actually have a picture in my head and see a longhouse and see people living there, and okay, I'm done with that. All right. Hey, Reverend Terri. Is ready for the children to come up to have a lesson. If there's anyone who isn't right over here. Is that me?
Yeah. Probably
not me.
I guess, how's that? Is that better? Okay. So, hi guys.
Did you know you guys are coming to my house for dinner tonight?
I know. You didn't know. Your brother knew. Yeah.
I knew too.
Yeah, you knew that too.
I'm excited about it. I'm going to look forward to being able to get to know you better.
He knows
every day. Hey, your dad tells you every day? Reese tells you. Oh, okay. So today, our lesson in the big church is about nature. Who climbs a tree? Who knows how to climb a tree? You do? You do?
Well,
you think, have you done it recently?
No, I don't have a good tree to climb.
So the tree that's the easiest to climb is the one that's the most dangerous because it has sap all over it. And it can burn when it's in the line, yeah. What do you have to say? You always climb the tree if you have a chance?
Yeah, and I always put sunscreen on because it doesn't burn.
That's right, sunscreen so you don't get burned is an excellent idea. So today at Big People Church, we're going to talk about trees and nature and how much it feeds our souls.
I love
it. You do love nature. Me too. Who else loves nature? Look at that. Everybody listens. I don't know if I can repeat all that. He says he loves the valleys, the mountains, the grasslands, the highlands, the lowlands, the ocean lands. Did I get them all? Rainforest and forest and caves. And other biomes, but not your belly. That's a biome too, isn't it? Are we part of nature?
Sure.
Do we have our own biome on each body?
Yeah.
In each body?
Yeah.
Yeah, you like your biome, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Your brothers? So today's lesson is all about we are part of nature. We are nature too. expressing. Isn't that amazing? Because we think that the trees are separate from us.
But no, they're not.
That's exactly right. No, they're not.
They're everywhere.
And we are a part of them, and they are a part of us. They do give us oxygen. What do we give them?
Carbon dioxide.
Carbon dioxide. We have brilliant people here. I could possibly teach you, and you certainly have taught us this morning. Thank you for sharing. You guys want to go and play now?
Yeah.
All right.
As modeled by Jesus and spiritual leaders of all faith traditions. It is your generosity that supports our youth program as well as our musicians. Thank you for your support. Do we have a minister center update today?
I do.
Okay.
Yeah. So one of the things that I've been, these updates, these are opportunities to provide a little transparency as to what's going on behind the scenes, but I'm not going to give you a whole bunch of details. I'm going to talk about this experience that I'm having right now. As a result of having read these three books that you all invited to be part of these book studies, one is it's a new concept. It's the idea that we are continuously emerging. The idea that the emerging church isn't necessarily the church of yesterday or even of today, and that this body is constantly being invited into something new and different, just as each of us as individuals are. I'm being with that idea as we, look at the cultural norms across the United States of church attendance going down, looking at Europe where they've already experienced such a deflation in the number of people who attend churches that mostly there aren't any. And so one of my questions over and over is, well, who have we come here to be? And I know for you, you've been around 10, 15, 10, 12 years, you've heard me use that line before. Who have we come here to be? And this is a question I believe that we need to be with over and over. It's not like, okay, well, we can figure out this is the plan and we're going to go with that plan and it's going to be successful. This is the plan for now. And then whatever comes up out of that plan, we'll see where we go from there. It's kind of like letting go of control and putting God in charge. Just saying. It's like that, right? It's putting the spiritual energy that we have intuitive knowledge of from our heart center, from our gut, in charge of our decision making, or at least in tandem with our decision making. So this is something that I've been with through the books I'm reading, through my prayer practices, also with the launch group. I have a group of people that we've been meeting for the last year, and I'm going to give you all a report at the annual meeting on the 28th after service of what we've covered and where we are now. But it's an idea that takes some moving into and reminding myself. As your leader, I'd really like to just come up with a plan that I know is going to work and then move forward and make that plan work. Wouldn't you like that? I mean, really, wouldn't that be great?
As long as it
agrees with what you want. Yes! Yes, and you, right? And so,
I want you to know about what's going on behind the scenes for me as your leader is I'm just continuously being open and trying to remind myself that I don't have to have all the answers right now, but I do have to see what's happening today and see where that's going to lead us tomorrow, just tomorrow, not for the rest of time. Okay, it's all my talking with hands. Thank you for letting me do that.
Now, as we transition to the prayer portion of our service, we prepare for the daily word. One of our prayer team members, I think it's Jeffrey, is going to come up. We're bringing the prayer request box up also. Today we affirm absolute faith in the goodness of God and that all beings receive of their highest good, and so it is.
Alright, let's all just take a deep breath in together. And out. Today's daily word is healing. God's healing power is moving through me. I am open and receptive to God's healing power within me and within my dear ones. I trust with absolute faith that God is greater than any worldly condition. I cannot limit God. I listen to the still, small voice within and feel guided along my healing journey. If fear and worry get the better of me, and I start to feel anxious, I call forth the healing power of the indwelling Christ. I spiritually surrender my concerns. When I pray for my dear ones, I do not focus on their condition. Rather, I see them as the divine beings they are, whole, prosperous, and spiritually perfect. As I pray, I perceive God's healing presence moving through me and my beloveds. This presence is the health beyond the illness, the abundance beyond the insufficiency, and the life beyond death. It is the truth of my life. From Isaiah, your healing shall spring up quickly. God's healing power is moving through me. Together, please. God's healing power is moving through me, and so it is.
At Unity, we believe in the power of prayer. There are two prayer boxes in the sanctuary, one at the front of the room and one in the back, with prayer request cards and pens. If you submit a prayer request, it will be held in prayer by our team, then sent to the Silent Unity, where your request will be held in prayer for an additional 30 days. Members of our prayer team are often available for a confidential prayer following the service. Is that the case?
It's a pray with your neighbor today.
Is it pray with your neighbor today? Okay. I'm available also. In the back of the sanctuary, usually, or right next to you. Let us affirm our statement of faith. Together?
There is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life. From the good, all power, presence, and wisdom. It is in God that I live, move, and have my being.
Today we have the absolute honor of welcoming Jamey Bellizzi, an extraordinary classical guitarist. Let's give him a big hand.
Thank you.
to you, this piece that he just played was written in 1697.
Yeah. Has anybody ever tried to play classical guitar?
I have to. That was a feat. Just for those of you who have not tried to play classical guitar, it takes years to become that skilled. Thank you so much for sharing your time with us. God is good?
All the time.
And all the time?
God is here.
God is here.
All the time.
And all the time?
God is here.
Yeah. The difference between these two is in our own understanding. Has anybody ever had a little bit of a hinky thing go on when you said God is good all the time? Yeah. Because we look at the way people use the power of God, it's just the only power that exists. And then sometimes people use it in ways that are damaging, painful. And we go, not so much that. And so I want to just say, well, God is here all the time. The principle of God is always here, present in this now moment. The principle of life, the principle of love, the principle of energy presence, this source of what is. It's always here, right? God is good all the time as the personal experience that we have when we turn within for guidance, compassion, love, and then growth into our own powerful natures. Will you agree with that statement?
Yes.
This is something that came up yesterday when I was meeting up with a small group, and we were like, I don't know if God is good all the time. And I gave it some thought. I agreed at the moment, and I thought, well, wait a minute. Yeah. The God within me is good all the time. By whatever name you have for that experience, right? That there is this place within us that has so much wisdom, love, compassion, and is constantly calling for forgiveness. Well, maybe not for you, for me, because I got stuff. So that power is the power that we want to tap into. This year I've been talking about discover the power. That's our aim for the whole year. And I've been focused on the 12 powers. In Unity, we recognize that there are 12 categories under which lots of powers can fall. So this January, we talked about faith, belief. We talked about love in February. We talked about, who remembers last month? Good job, strength. You make me so proud. Determination. And April is about wisdom. Now, I just want to give you a little information about wisdom. It used to be known as judgment. That was the noise I heard. Because judgment has taken on culturally a meaning in our society that would also be equal to condemnation, right? But if I just put the word good in front of it, then it's not so hard to swallow, right? Good judgment. You want to use good judgment. You have the power of good judgment. Do you? Yes. We all have the power of good judgment. Do we always use it?
Yes.
There's one who says yes. Thank you. Thank you for always using it. The interesting thing about this is that all of these powers that we are talking about, faith, love, strength, and wisdom, judgment, that these are unique to humanity. Not in that, I think that there are other animal species that have experiences of love, perhaps, of wisdom, perhaps, but that we get to choose them even in the face of fear. We get to choose faith in the face of fear. That's not an animal thing. We get to choose love when we've been hurt. We get to choose strength when we feel weak. We get to choose to turn within for the highest wisdom that we can find when our brain says, I know the answer. Right? I mean, that's, okay, maybe that happens to me. So this is the power of God in our lives. I believe that is the power of the 12 powers. When we say discover the power within, we're talking about something that is uniquely human to discover this power that we have to be the good, to hear the good, even in the midst of what we might call not so good. Are you all on board?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So I want to talk about metaphysics for a minute. I said I would. Let's see where it is. Hold on. Ah. Metaphysics. I said I was going to talk about heaven and earth. Does anybody want to take a stab at what heaven is metaphysically? I know somebody knows. Do you have the mic? Go ahead, think about it for a moment. I'm coming out with the mic. Metaphysically, what does heaven represent?
A state of consciousness.
Okay, a state of consciousness, the highest state of consciousness, that state of consciousness that we can move into by turning within and overcoming or walking through the upset of daily life, right? And what does earth represent? Somebody else? Oh, come on, it's not that hard. Just make it up. Come on. The ego self? All right, that's good. That's a good one. Yes, sure. Earth represents the physical manifestation of life. And yeah, I can see how it would also represent the ego self. Yeah, but I'm not gonna use that one today. I'll use that one another day. So, heaven and earth are the experiences of the divine. It's our experience of the divine. The physical manifestation, our bodies, our buildings, this lectern, paper, all these physical manifestations are expressions out of our minds, out of the ideas, divine ideas that we have. Some of these physical manifestations are really good. And then sometimes we see physical manifestations that might not be so good, or that might have started out as good and then turned into something maybe not so good, or created results that are not so good. I got a participant, but I'm not gonna go there. So that's... So the deal is that we get to choose our experience of heaven. And by choosing a consciousness, turning within, and choosing a consciousness of what we believe the divine presence would invite us into, that manifests in the world. Whatever it is we create, whatever it is we do, becomes a manifestation, therefore, of God. Y'all on board still? Okay. Anybody ever hear of the book, children's book, Ted Bear's Magic Swing? Oh, gosh. Such a good book. I didn't bring it, but I'll just tell you the outside here. It's all the bears are characters, or all the animals are characters. So Ted Bear has a magic swing in the forest. It's in the favorite part of the forest. And he likes to go there every day after lunch and swing. And he just looks at the trees and enjoys the sky and relaxes. Now, Ted Bear is a very busy bear. He's responsible for all the bear's honey, all the bears in the whole forest. He's responsible for keeping track of it, making sure everybody gets enough. He's responsible for making sure the bees don't get upset, so that they continue to produce honey. Now, this is not just some unimportant, he's not filing papers. That is important, but not as important. So one day, from the little hedgehog. She had a bunch of baby hedgehogs, and she was just beside herself. Just beside herself. Because she had all these hedgehogs doing all these hedgehog things, and she was exhausted trying to keep them from hurting each other and hurting the earth themselves. And so Ted Bear happened to be walking by, and he's whistling and smiling. And she's like, how come you're always happy? And you always look like everything's easy. And he says, well, I think it might be my magic swing. And so he invites her to go, and sure enough, she goes to the magic swing, she takes a break, and then when she returns, she's able to be with her kids, even if they hurt each other. All those little baby hedgehogs, you can't make it not happen. But she's able to be present. And then it was one animal after another animal, because all those animals in the forest, you know, they're very busy. The story is about taking time in nature and turning within, just being present to what is here and now. And that experience allows us to enjoy the whole rest of our lives, all the rest of the day, in a way that we couldn't before, when we're all caught up in this stuff. See, judgment is this thing that says, this is too hard. This is challenging. This is easy. I have what I need to be with this. All of those are judgment statements, right? Do you hear that I've made a proclamation? I've made a proclamation, it's a beautiful day. Well, that's a good judgment, so I'm good with it. It's whatever the judgment, I'm not good enough. Anybody ever have that one show up in your consciousness? Yeah, So any of those kinds of statements about others or ourselves, those are a judgment. Those come from not within. Those are judgments made from our head up and from our senses, our five senses. What are they? Eyes, ears, taste, nose, touch, right? And so we're invited to turn within to that sixth sense, that sixth sense of the divine. And then when we do that in judgment, it's still judgment, but it's wise judgment. So every day is judgment day. Judgment day happens all day long, every day. That's the unity take. You good? I mean, this is it. I mean, we are constantly proclaiming judgment about things. That's it. The judgment day is the experience that we have when we've decided something is good or bad or right or wrong, or I'm good or bad, or you're good or bad, or right or wrong. That's it. When we turn within to that power within, then suddenly faith or fear turns into faith, hurt turns into love, weakness turns into strength, and knowledge, judgment, turns into wisdom. That's what discovering the power within is all about. All right, what else do I want to say? Oh, as above, so below, as within, so without. That's the Bible saying that Jesus supposedly said, maybe he didn't. Regardless of whether he did or not, his students thought they did, that he did. That whatever we hold in consciousness from here, that becomes our experience of the world. Y'all on board? Okay. Anybody going? Yeah, no. Just want to check. You good at home? Checking in. Okay. According to the revealing word, the metaphysical meaning of the word, nature is God. That's something that Charles Fillmore worked with word people. There's a name for them. People who study words in lots of different languages. Linguists. Thank you. Charles Fillmore, our co-founder, worked with linguists to come up with the root meanings for words, and this was one that he and they came together with. Nature is our word for God. Fascinating, right? I was a little surprised to see that. So God's great outdoors. How many of you would like to experience God as the great outdoors? Okay. Yeah. We like it in our architecture, in our art. We like to use nature's colors on our bodies. Sky colors, flower colors. Nature is seen as a place for healing and personal growth. Many of you know that people are taking forest baths these days, right? It's that walking into the forest and becoming so open in consciousness that you can recognize that the atoms of the trees are part of the atoms of my body, that the carbon dioxide that I breathe out is being breathed in by the trees, and that the oxygen that the trees are giving off are being breathed in by me, and that makes us one. There's a whole bunch more. Over 100 studies, scientific studies, I'm going to read from research now, have shown that being in nature, living near nature, or even looking at nature in paintings and videos can have positive impacts on our brains, bodies, feelings, thought processes, and social interactions. If you're not getting along with people, go hang out in the trees. In particular, viewing nature seems to be inherently rewarding, producing a cascade of positive emotions and calming our nervous systems. Did you need the research to tell you that? Okay. All right. John Muir wrote, this is about the Sierra Nevadas. We are now in the mountains, and they are in us, kindling enthusiasm, making every nerve quiver, filling every pore and cell of us. Another study showed that watching an inspiring documentary on planet Earth led people to feel 46% more awe and 31% more gratitude than those who watched the news or even comedy. Now, I like comedy, but nature, watching nature, fills us with more awe and gratitude than even comedy. It reduces stress, decreases healing time for surgeries, the list go on and on and on. And I got lost in all my papers because I didn't remember them. That happens sometimes. Hang in there with me. Y'all good?
Yeah.
Yeah, think about these things that I'm telling you. Just think about how important, how earth-shattering they are to you, how much it's going to change your life. There it is. So, there's an ancient Chinese proverb about a Chinese farmer who has a son born, and people come to his house and say, "Congratulations, a boy," and he says, "We'll see." And then his boy grows up and he's helping him be the, you know, take care of the farm. And they say, "Congratulations, he's a wonderful, wonderful boy being of service to you." And he says, "Well, we'll see." And then the boy's on the horse and he falls off the horse and he breaks his leg. And the neighbors come over and say, "Whew, he lived. Congratulations, his leg is going to heal and the horse is fine. Jeez, that's great. He says, well, we'll see. And then war breaks out in the land. And the neighbors come over again. It's a good thing he got that broken leg. He says, we'll see. There is no punchline in the story. That's the story that we'll see, right? We'll see whether it's good or bad, but we can choose to call it good if we want. This is the deal, is that we have that power as humans over, there's nothing else that has the power to choose. It's pretty amazing. Do y'all see? Sometimes when I think about it, I'm just sort of blown away. Today I'm going to do a special meditation that I found online because I just loved it. And it's going to be a meditation using the five elements, fire, water, air, earth, and?
Fear.
Close, ether. Yes, spirit, ether. The fifth element being that space in between. Right? We know science now is talking about there's more space in between than there is of matter. And so the ether is what we're going to call it. You can call it spirit when I say ether. That's fine with me. This unity is really about discovering the power within you so that you have that power available to you in your life. I don't know about you, but I have not reached perfection yet. And frankly, I'm not really interested. I'm interested in having an experience of heaven here and now, of being able to accept myself with all my weird stuff and sometimes with the hurts I cause other people so that I can go ahead and choose love over it. You know, hurts I have myself, so I can choose forgiveness over it. This is a beautiful experience we're having, and because we turn within, that power of prayer, I believe prayer is the turning in, and meditation is aligning with the principle, right? Prayer is being able to turn to that personal experience of the divine within ourselves. Meditation is aligning our minds and hearts with the principles of what God is. Life, health, meaning. Got it? Okay. That's discover the power within you. That's it. Should we go to meditation? Oh yeah, that was it. I was going to tell y'all, I didn't write it down. Go out in the forest every day this week if you can. That is something. You can't get out there every day for at least 5 minutes and just put some time on your calendar to go out there and let the forest move through you.
Let's breathe that message into our heart and mind. Take a couple of nice deep breaths. We invite you to sing with us.
With every breath I take, in and out, it's whole.
With every beat of my heart, there's no
settling into the seat beneath you for a moment. Maybe wiggling your body if that's necessary, so that you can be comfortable. Rest your hands lightly on your thighs. And gently close your eyes. If any of this is uncomfortable, move your body into the position that is comfortable. Without changing anything, bring your awareness to the breath. Simply observe the sensations as your breath moves in and out of your body. Perhaps the rise and fall of the belly, the movement of air in your nose or on your lips. But the quiet noise of air flowing in and out, or the noise of humans and nature around us. Allow each breath to calm the body and your mind, and focus your awareness on the present moment. With each inhale, become aware of the force of nature within you. Feel this life energy animate your body, your skeleton, lifting your chest, lengthening your spine. Invite each inhalation to bring awareness and alertness to your senses, the sounds near and far, the temperature, the feeling of your weight being supported by the earth beneath you. Any aromas floating in the air. And with each exhale, feel your body release and relax. Inhale and recall a peaceful scene from nature in your mind's eye. Whether you visualize the beach, the mountains, or a forest, move your eyes behind your eyelids from left to right, and up and down. Perhaps you can imagine animals grazing or birds flying up above. Imagine the sounds that would be present. Maybe the sound of a bird or the sound of waves washing ashore. Feel the sun and the wind against your skin, the earth beneath you. Perhaps you can smell or even taste the pine and the salt and the fresh air. Each exhale brings you to a deeper sense of serenity. The elements of nature, fire, air, water, earth, and ether, are the forces that drive creation, preservation, and transformation. They enable the wonderful experience of life and beauty of the world in which we live. As you breathe in, visualize an image of fire. Our ability to use fire is a distinctly human power. As you focus on that image of fire, feel the energy of transforming power flowing into you. And as you exhale, allow your body to release and relax. you focus on that image, feel the energy of strength flowing into you. As you exhale, allow your body to release and relax, feeling the power of nature. Quality of strength and new directions. For water, imagine the ocean waves moving along the shoreline or a lake on a summer day. And as you focus on that image, feel the energy of wisdom and intuition flowing into you. Again, on the exhale, relax, release, focusing on the quality of wisdom and intuition. For earth, imagine a beautiful landscape or a lush garden. And as you focus on that image, feel the energy of faith flowing into you. As you exhale, allow your body to release and relax. Focusing on that image, feeling the quality of faith and stability, the power of nature. And for ether, bring to mind a picture of outer space, perhaps something from the James Webb telescope, or maybe the subtle space between each cell in the body. As you focus on the image you've chosen, feel the energy of love that binds it all together. Love that harmonizes, that is cohesive, feeling the power of nature. Air, earth, water, ether, and fire. We are nature. I invite you to take another deep breath. And release. Bring your awareness back to your body and your senses, what you hear, what you feel. Feel that deep connection and harmony that you created with an awareness. The power within you. Open your eyes when you're ready and return to this time and this space.
Every breath I take,
We know that everyone is here today by divine appointment, not by accident. If you're new to Unity of Olympia, we'd love to get to know you better. Please join us in the social hall after service for some refreshments. There's a welcome table there and more information about Unity, and if you complete the guest survey and return it to the folks at that table, you even get a gift. Welcome team members have a green ribbon, and they're available to introduce you to others from our community or answer any questions you might have. If you are a newcomer and did not receive a welcome packet, please stop by the welcome desk to pick one up. There's a guest survey inside, and if you fill it out, didn't I just say that? There is a gift for you. Who wrote this thing? All right, and now it is time for conscious contributions. Will the ushers please come forward? As a spiritual cooperative, we each give what we can to support our community. In this way, we put our feet to our faith, and in the natural abundance of God's world, we invite our guests to receive today's service as our gift to you. As always, you can make your conscious contributions on our website or via Venmo. You can put it in the mail, or you can give here. In whatever way you choose to support this community, take your gifts in your hands, hearts, and minds, and let us bless them with divine love. Together?
Divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive.
Jamey Bellizzi. Thank you.
strength, of hope, of gratitude, of love, and perseverance that this community is working together to create more spiritual awakening for people to choose the power within. We pray knowing that these gifts go forward to bless all the world. And so it is. Thank you, God.
Thank you.
Amen. Guess what? We have one more piece being offered to us today. Jamey is going to play Morning Has Broken in honor of Rick Ricola. Oh, yes. Is it Ricola? Ricola. I said Ricola. It's not Ricola. That's the pop drum. It's Ricola. Who is in the hospital right now, and so I invite you all into holding an energy of healing, health, well-being, peace, love, and God's presence in his body and in his life while we get to listen to this beautiful piece. Thanks, Jamey. Spirit group is meeting. I'm doing a spirit group at my house on meeting myself in the Bible Spirit Group, that's Wednesdays at 2. Ignore the Tuesday. Pretend it says Wednesday. You have the power. You have the power. And there are 3 spaces open still if you're interested in doing metaphysics in the Bible. What else is there? Meditation and release. Oh, look at that. Thurston County Hunger Walk. So if you don't know about the Thurston County Hunger Walk, Unity of Olympia has been supporting the food bank through this event since before it was called the Thurston County Hunger Walk, back in the days when it was called Crop Walk. And this is a huge event that supplements the funds that the Thurston County Food Bank and another organization that feeds people uses to feed people, right? So if you have not already done this, go online and give your money. Thurston County said, well, I'm goal of $500. I know I put in 30. I saw Ann put in 50. I have no idea what's happened in the last 2 weeks. So maybe we're at 500. If that's true, if we have already set our better goal, then put in 50 anyway. We change the goal to 1,000. Okay? We want to support people having enough food. And then everything else you can find online. That's it.
These flowers are brought to us today by Nancy Kamenzine, and I am stunned by this beautiful arrangement. And a little bird floated down and whispered in my ear that these are to go to our wonderful Janene.
Aww.